won't be in bondage to any man. John 8:33, we the descendants of Abraham, yea, shall be made free. John 8:36, to whom the Son set free is free indeed. He say the wretch like me.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
What's going on, God Gold family? I want to share with you a little different kind of God Gold. Today we're going to be talking about truth. Truth. And we always hear about God's promises and how God makes promises in his word that are promises that give us faith, that give us something to hold on to stand firm on, that when we're going through tough times, we can hold on to these verses of promises from God, of these verses of truth, and we can say, all right, like I can get through this because of who you are, not because of who I am, because of the truth that you have given to me. So I want to talk about truth, and we're going to do this a couple times, probably a month or so, and we're going to pray over these verses of truth. Today's verse is John 1:5. It says, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. And in verse 4, in him, it says, in Jesus was life, and the life was the light of men. So it compares this life in Jesus to light, and it says, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. So that is truth, verse 5 right there. That is some truth today that we can hold on to. Because think about situations where your darkness surrounds you, your darkness comes up and creeps in your life and reminds you of all the times you failed, gives you doubt, insecurities, worries, fear above all else. Darkness just overcomes you, overcomes us, overcomes myself so much. And it creeps in. But when we hold on to God's truth, when we hold on to this truth in God's word, because that is where truth is found. The verse in John, the book of John, that says the truth will set you free. When you read this truth, when you're going through something and you're facing all those doubts, because I had this happen to me last week, a couple different occasions, the morning that I read this verse, there was times in my day I wanted to give up. I wanted to go home. I wanted to quit. I was just done. I didn't want to do it anymore. I didn't see any purpose in it anymore. And then in that moment, the verse that I read that morning, the light shines in the darkness and the darkness has not overcome it. Reading that verse that morning, it just popped right back into my head and reminded me, hey, you ain't got nothing to worry about because the darkness can't touch you. You are one with Jesus. And it says the light that shines in Jesus, it shines in the darkness. It comes into the darkness, shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The darkness will never overcome it. The darkness can't overcome it because Jesus' light and who Jesus is stronger than any form of darkness an enemy can throw at us and or any darkness that we find in ourselves that creeps in on a daily basis. So this is a verse that we can hold on to, a verse of truth. And what God's truth does, it changes our thinking. It changes the way we do things. It changes our belief. And our belief changes, everything else changes. Because our belief is in Christ and not what we see and not in us. And before I go any farther and talk too much, I just want to share this verse with you today. John 1:5. And I want to give this truth to you for something you to hold on to, something for you to meditate on. And for something you to remember in those moments when you are going through some stuff. So I want to pray for you real quick. And I just hope this truth is an encouragement to you today. And I hope it sets you free today. Because it will. I promise you it will. It has me in so many ways already. Thank you, Lord, so much for today. Thank you for all you do in our lives. Thank you for your truth, Lord. Thank you for how powerful your truth is. Thank you for how your truth sets us free. And I pray for each and every person watching this, Lord. I pray whatever they're going on, what's going on in their life, whatever they're struggling with, whatever doubt or insecurities or fear they have in their lives where they think they are not enough, when they think that they can't move forward, Lord, I pray you would just bring your truth and show them that the light, your light shines in that darkness and the darkness cannot overcome it. I pray you would just remind them of that truth, Lord. That truth, and let it just pick them up, Lord. Pick them up with your truth and move them forward to not be overcome by darkness, but to be overcomers in your light, Lord. Thank you so, so much, Lord, for loving us, for sending your son to die for us and giving us life, Lord, for sending your son to bring us life, to be the light of men, that we have the greatest truth to hold on to in your son, Jesus Christ. And I pray that whoever's watching this today is encouraged and moved closer to you, Lord. And I pray you would just be with them and provide for them in whatever they need, Lord. Thank you so, so much. You are so good, God. In your holy and precious name I pray, amen. Y'all have a great day. See you guys.
Won't be in bondage to any man. John 8:33. We the descendants of Abraham. Yea, shall be made free. John 8:36. To whom the Son set free is free indeed. He say the wretch like me.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.